subject is Environmental Studies Part 1 of Standard 4th and name of the lesson is Transport and Communication. Dear children, here we can see some pictures. These are nothing but they are related to transport and communication, isn't it? Right? Yes, these objects, they play an important role in our life. Without these objects, it is very difficult to think about our life, isn't it? Yes, we are used to all these items, right? Now, in this lesson, we will go through about the transport of the ancient times and nowadays. Okay? Like that only, we will go through about the communication of ancient period and nowadays. Okay? Yes. Here you can see some means and modes of transportation. Please observe these pictures. This is from your textbook. Here we can see some old transport systems and some advanced and new transport systems. Isn't it? See, this is a porter carrying the goods. Here this donkey is carrying the goods. Here we can see cycle, motorcycle, and here we can see rocket, isn't it? We use this rocket to transport or to travel high above or away from the earth. Right? This is truck. It helps us to take away the goods from one place to another. This is boat we used in water to travel or to transport the material. Isn't it? Yes, dear children. The means of transport we use nowadays are faster and safer than the older ones. Right? Here, man used to see logs of wood and round boulders rolling down the mountain slope. He observed this, that logs of wood, they are rolling down from the mountain. It is thought that these observations gave him the idea of the wheel. See, afterwards, he used the logs together to carry the loads. Okay, and afterwards, on this idea, he prepared the wheel. Correct? Yes, we will go through in detail. See, this is one more picture. So many people, they are carrying the heavy load by using the wooden logs tied together. In olden days, planks of wood were used to transport objects. See, this is a plank of wood. One more picture you can see here. See this. They used to drag this and they used to carry the heavy loads. But it was so difficult to drag this. Later, what happened? See, the wheel was invented. See, this is a heavy wheel, heavy wooden wheel. Slowly, see, this is the progress. Later, by attaching wheels to this plank, the speed of transport increased. Here you can see the wheel with spokes. This is a light wheel, but this is also made up of wood. Because of these spokes, the wheel became lighter. Got this? And it is attached to the planks and they used to carry the heavy loads. The invention of the wheel is an important step in the progress of mankind. Even if ultra-modern means of transport have been invented in modern times. See this. This is a yak. Y-A-K. Yak. See here. In some parts of the world, men and animals are still used for the purpose of transport. See the picture. This is a mountainous area. Here the axe can easily move. Horses are used in inaccessible parts. See again, this is a very narrow and steep road, right? Here, the horse can move easily and it is very difficult for us to move in this area. So, man uses horse to go up on the mountainous areas. Palkis or dolies are used in mountainous areas. See, these are called palkis or dolies. See, dear children, we go to worship God in holy places, isn't it? Here our temples are on mountains. So many temples we can see on the mountainous areas. Here, for the sick people and for the old people, it becomes very difficult to climb that mountain. Then they use like these palkis. The palkis were carried by the people. Right? Like this. They go to the temple and they worship their deity. Right? Camels are used in the desert area. You know, camels are called as sheep of desert. Camels can sustain the heat of the desert. Desert is very hot place, isn't it? It emits heat. But these camels, they are capable of sustaining this heat. So, we use camels in the desert areas to move from one place to another. Water and wind are substances that flow. We know that water and wind, they flow from one place to another. Right? Pipes are used to transport these substances. We know this because we have pipelines all over Mumbai. And water from the pipes we get in each house. Isn't it? So water has been transported through pipes and canals since ancient times. Our water sources are far away from our city areas. And water is transported from that water source to each and every house by pipelines. Isn't it? It is safer to transport combustible substances. Here, combustible substance means they catch fire easily. They burn easily. That is called combustible substance, like oil, petrol, got that? Diesel, like this. It is safer to transport combustible substances such as mineral oil and natural gas through pipes. Yes, it is very safe to transport these items through the pipelines. Similarly, after refining, it is transported through pipelines to the marketplace in some parts. Got that? It is safer and easy to transport through the pipes. Here I will show you one example. See, dear children, this is Mumbai High Oil Well. This is in Arabian Sea. Okay? And here you can see the oil refinery. In this Mumbai High, we get crude oil, means impure oil, okay, that should be refined to use. Got this? So, how to transport this crude oil to the oil refinery? Yes, now we know that they use pipelines, isn't it? See, like this, they use the pipelines to transport the crude oil to the oil refinery. Okay? And what happens in the oil refinery? The oil is refined and then it is distributed to the other parts of the city to use. Now, one more example I want to give. This we can see throughout Mumbai. This is Mahanagar Gas. Yes, dear children, here they also use pipelines to pass the gas, okay, to each and every house. You have seen these pipelines on most of the buildings, right? And from these pipelines, we get the gas to our kitchen. Correct? Here also we use pipelines because it is very safe and easy to transport the gas from one place to another. Right? Now, dear children, we use some vehicles to transport goods. Now, just now we studied about the water, that is liquid and gas states, right? Now we will come to solid state. We use some vehicles to transport goods. See here, in the village area, they use bullock carts to transport their goods from one place to another, right? And in city area, we use trucks, big containers, and the goods train, right? These vehicles, they help us to transfer or to carry the heavy loads from one place to another. Most of you have seen all these pictures in your day-to-day life, isn't it? Now, dear children, here there are four types of vehicles we can see. Okay, these are land vehicles, means these move on land. See here, bicycles, motorcycles, rickshaw, and cars, jeeps, and buses, etc. So many vehicles we can see on the road. These are nothing but land vehicles. They move on road. They need proper road to move, right? And here we can see the railways. See these railways or monorails or metro and bullet trains. These needs track, separate track they need to move from one place to another. They don't move on the road directly. The track is must for them to move. Got this? These are called railways. Here rail means track. Ways means road. Track road is nothing but railways. Okay, got this? And the next one is, you know that airways means air road. They move in the air. For example, helicopter and planes. They move in the air. They don't need any roads. Correct? The next one is waterways. Here, these vehicles need water to move from one place to another. Small boats, big boats, ships, they need water. Okay? Now you can see this, a rocket. This moves in the space that is away from the earth. Correct? Yes, dear children, I hope you understood about the transportation of earlier days and the transportation of nowadays, how we use the pipelines for transportation of combustible substances, and what all we use to transport the solid substances, right? Okay, now if you know all of them properly, then tell me the answers for this. Match the following. Here there are two columns. In this first column you can see three sentences, that is, to travel far from the earth, which vehicle we are going to use? To carry heavy loads and to travel through water, which vehicles we use, that you have to tell. Yes, here in this side we can see a boat, a rocket, a push cart with wheels. Yes, dear children, come on, guess the answer. Yes, to travel far from the earth, we use a rocket. Second, to carry heavy loads on land, we use a pushcart with wheels. To travel through water, we use a boat. Very good. One more question for you. Yes, before that, tell me the answer for this. Avoid unnecessary use of means of transport. Here you can see two pictures. In the first picture, these two people, they are using their own vehicle to move from one place to another. And here, these people, they are going in a public vehicle. You can see the bus number and bus route here. Come on, dear children, tell me which is the right one. Which one we have to avoid? This one or going in public vehicle? Yes, very good. This is the wrong thing they are doing. We can use to move from one place to another or to the nearer place. We can use the public vehicle. Because in one vehicle, 60 to 70 people, they can move from one place to another. Because of this, we can minimize the pollution. Right? And we can minimize the use of the natural sources like petrol, diesel, etc. Yes, dear children, you have to think on this before using your private vehicles to move to the smaller distances. Now, here one question. Manjeet and Salim have to bring water from a mountain. However, since the weight of the water is too much for them, it is not possible to carry the water from the mountain to the ground. Yes, Then which of the following options should they use? Come on, tell me. Here three options are there: a horse, a pipeline, and a palki. Here you can see the picture. Come on, tell me. What do you suggest to them? Tell them the solution for this problem. Yes, very good. A pipeline is best for this problem, isn't it? Yes, dear children, now please observe this picture and think for a minute. What they are doing? Who are they? What is going on? What it tells us? Yes, very good. They are talking to each other. They are conversing with each other. Some are expressing their views, ideas to others. Some are sharing their ideas with others. Some are giving solutions to others' problem after listening their problems. Yes. Overall, this picture tells us about the communication. Isn't it? Very good. Now, dear children, here you can see some means and modes of communication. You can see here the different methods of communications too. See the bird flying with the message. A man is giving the message here. Here as you can see, the man is declaring some important rules, something, whatever. Here the postman with the letters. Here this man is getting some information from the newspaper. This, you know, radio, TV, computer, mobile, satellite. These all are the means of communication. Some we used in earlier days and some we are using nowadays, isn't it? Obtaining and sending various types of information is called communication. Yes, the real meaning of communication is nothing but exchange of information. Taking or giving information, obtaining or sending information is nothing but communication. Okay? In the beginning, we will go through from the ancient period. Okay? Man used gestures and facial expressions and different kinds of sounds to communicate. He wasn't new about the language, writing, right? So he used to make some gestures and expressions, facial expressions used to make to tell something to the other people. Afterwards, he started to make the sound. Okay? Some special sounds for to tell about the warning, to tell about the arrival of the wild animal nearby, like this. He used different types of sound to warn the other people. Like this, slowly this led to the development of language. See, after spoken language, man invented writing. I don't know which language this one, but they slowly changed from language to writing the information, whatever. This we got from the caves and all that. He began to carve his thoughts onto the walls of caves and pieces of wood. You know, and you have studied all these about the ancient period in history, isn't it? How they slowly progress towards the advanced period. From Stone Age to Medieval, and from Medieval to the Modern Age. We can see so many progress in mankind, isn't it? See, ancient and primitive forms of communication. Communication began in this way in very ancient times. See, cave painting, afterwards smoke signal. They used to make the smoke to alert the other people or to give them some information. They used smokes. And here clay tablet means here that is written form. Okay, he is a runner, marathon runner, and lighthouse to tell about the danger or about the big stones in the waterways. See, dear children, here pigeons with messages attached. Here in the circle you can see the messages or the information are transferred from one place to another by using these birds, that is pigeons. We have heard about all this in the stories, isn't it? See, he is a runner. He used to run from one place to another to give the important message. He never used to take rest in between. Always he used to run, so he was called as runner. After that, telegram machine came into use. In this telegram machine, we used to inform the important and short messages. Got this? And after that, postal services came into use. You know about the postal service and letters, right? But all these methods were very slow as compared to modern methods. See, dear children, here we can see some modern means of communication. See, these computers, radio, telephone, mobile, correct? TV, etc. These are fastest means of communication. Compared to this newspaper, letters, magazines, right? See, nowadays because of this coronavirus pandemic, you are always going through the online classes. Schools are closed, right? But our studies are going, they are continued on online classes. Your teacher takes online classes daily, isn't it? See, this is the fastest and advanced mean of communication. She will be at school or at her home, and you are sitting at your homes. She gives the lecture online, and at the same time, you can hear her voice, you can see the pictures, correct? You can see her directly. So this is the advanced mode of communication. right? Say that because of this advanced technology, the world is moving. Yes, dear children, this is from your textbook. Read the passage given below and answer the following questions. Yes, you have to read this passage, and here you can see some modes of communication and some modes of transportation. Okay? And this is activity for you. Some questions are asked below this passage on page number 136. Please go through them and try to answer them after reading this passage. Okay? Now, we will move to now animal side. See, dear children, like human being, animals also communicate with each other. In this picture, you can go through this. When animals, they are happy, observe the sound. When they are in fear, observe the sound. And when they are scared or when they are hurt or when they are injured, they make different type of sounds. Like us, they also send and receive messages. You know that crow, it calls his friends when he gets the food, isn't it? He makes a different type of sound to call them. Dear children, observe these pictures. These are live shows. We can see them live on the TV or in the cinema. Correct? The recording and the show is going on in different places or in faraway places from our place. We can watch these live programs on TV or in computer, isn't it? But see these. This is a clown, Joker. We can see him in the circus. This is a magic show. We can see in the fair, right? Here he is, Shahid. He is singing and he is passing some important story or information. Now, this is bioscope. See, this is a puppet show. He also tells us about the morals or some culture of the state. This is a street play. Here also these children, they are showing us some valuable or important information by their act. Yes, dear children, come on, tell me, see the two blocks here. In the first block, we can see the live recordings, and here in the second one, we can see the live persons. Right? Here we can meet these people personally. When they show their programs, when they come to show their programs, we can meet them, we can talk to them because they are near to us. Right? But here we cannot talk to them because they are far away from us. Right? This is the main difference between these two. And these programs, whatever we see on the TV, are performed somewhere far away. They are filmed and recorded there and then transmitted to us. We can see and hear the programs using the devices like TV, computer, radio, etc. For this, these are the means of entertainment that transmit programs. Come on, dear children, tell me, which of the following are not a means of transmission? I think you came to know about the meaning of transmission here, right? Transmission means they are acting far away from us, and then the acting was recorded and transmitted, and we get that live or the recorded program in the modern devices like TV, computer, etc. That devices are called as transmitting devices. Okay, here we can see radio, television, puppet theater, cinema. Yes, in radio, yes, transmission is needed. Television, here also. In cinema theater also, nowadays, they use the method of transmission. Here only the puppet theater. This is not using any transmission. Here the man, he comes to the theater and then he shows the puppet show, right? Meena has to send a very important message to a distant place right away. Which means of communication do you think she should use? Yes, Meena, a girl, she wanted to send one very, very important message to her dad, who is staying in America. Yes, dear children, which means of communication she should use according to you? Yes, very good. She must use either cell or mobile, or she must use the computer or PC or tablet. Right? These are nothing but the advanced means of communication. Right? Yes, dear children, do you know? Recently, the use of mobile phones has increased. We can see this picture everywhere. Right? Each and every one has his own mobile. And he is or she is always using their mobile continuously, isn't it? Because of this happening, you know, our beloved sparrows are disturbed by the waves coming from mobile phones. Small birds, very delicate birds, sparrows, they are disturbed by the waves coming from mobile phones. That is why sparrows are dying and they are disappearing from our environment. So poor fellows. Yes, dear children, you know that film 2.0, correct? That is on the same problem. Right? Always remember, means of transport and communication are to be used as needed. Yes, how much possible to minimize the use, that you have to minimize. Okay, excess use of these means is harmful for us, for all living beings, as well as for the environment. Remember, dear children, don't use your private vehicle to move to nearer places. Okay? If you go by walking, then it is well and good. If we use cycle, that is also very good. Otherwise, you can use the public vehicles. Second thing is, use your mobile whenever you are in need of that one. Okay? Remember this. Because of this, you can save the sparrows, you can save yourself, and you can save our environment too. Because you are the future citizens of our country. You must have to follow all this. Am I right? Now, dear children, we will take a quick recap of what we have learned today. First one, information about modes of transport in different periods of time. Right? Second, the importance of the invention of the wheel. Right? Next is means of communication in different periods of time. Last one, live entertainment and means of transmission. Yes, dear children, please go through the lesson once and try to understand the lesson and try to follow the things which were very useful for our environment.